In this video, I'm going to go over how to connect Google Sheets and BigQuery. And we're going to do it both ways. So what I mean by that is we're going to get BigQuery data to Google Sheets, which is something that's called connected sheets. And then we will also do an example of getting Google Sheets data to BigQuery. So let's get started with connected sheets, which means basically we're going to take BigQuery data and move it to Google Sheets. And I have this empty Google Sheets file. As you can see, it's called Connect Google Sheets to BigQuery Connected Sheets. It's just a name, doesn't really matter what it's called, but it's an empty Google Sheets spreadsheet. And then I got my BigQuery right here, where I have my sales data dataset, and I got a couple of tables, customers and products. I'm not gonna go over how to set up BigQuery in this video. I will link to a video below this that goes over how to set up BigQuery so you understand what's a project, what's a project ID, what's a data set, what's a table, all those things you need to know to be able to successfully use this. And also you need to know how to write some queries, which again, it's gonna be all in the video I'm gonna link in the description, which is basically just BigQuery tutorial just to get you up to speed. So I got this set up. So as you can see, I got this project. It's called My Project 25045. And this is the actual project ID, this organic justice, this number. Within that, I have this sales data data set, and I got two tables. So first of all, let's just do a quick query from this customers table. So I'll go ahead and add a new query window. And what I'll do here, I'll just do a quick select statement. So I'll just do select star, meaning all columns from, and then I'll take that organic justice ID. And inside of this, we have sales data data set. And within this, we're gonna get that customers table. So I'll do some filters on this, but let's just go ahead and add a semicolon and run this so you can see what this looks like. So as you can see, I got this data with 10,000 records. We got some of this information. So let's go ahead and filter this by state. So I'll go ahead and add a filter by state column, and we'll make it equal Illinois. So let's go ahead and run this. So you can see now I got 480 results, which should be just those that match this criteria. So that's pretty much it. This can be any query. So this is just one example. You just want to make sure you write the query you're actually trying to get. So now let's try to get this data in this Google Sheets spreadsheet. So what I'll do here, I'll go to data, and I'm going to move to data connectors. And here we have this option, connect to BigQuery. So this will list all the projects you have available under your account. So you can see now this is that ID, organic justice. That's the one I want. So I'm going to click on that. So now it's going to show me what data sets I have within that project, which is sales data is the data set. And here we basically have different tables. So you can just pick one of these tables. So this is fine. You can actually do this. And what it's going to do, if you just select one of these, it will just grab the entire table and pull it over. But typically, if you're working with BigQuery, you're probably not going to pull that entire thing to Google Sheets. So what we're going to do instead of picking one of these, we're just going to write a custom query right here. So I'll just click on that. And this window is where your query is going to go. And basically, I'll just go back and copy this SQL statement I did here and go back to here and just paste it here. Just that simple. So if I just do preview results, you'll see it shows me those results now here and those same 480 lines, as you can see. So we can go ahead and click connect. And that's it. We're done. We're connected. So I'm going to close this. So you can see I got all of this data. Later, if you want to refresh this data with new data you get in your database, you can just click refresh and it's going to pull that data. Now, using this data, you can now do different things. So you can take this data and now build a pivot table on top of that. Or you can add calculated columns, basically calculate something with a few different columns from this database and things like that. So let's just go ahead and rename this. This is called connected sheets. So I'll just call it my BigQuery connection. It's just a name. You can call it anything you like. And that's going to be the tab name down here. And at this point, I can take this and make a pivot table. And maybe in rows, I can add gender. And in values, I can add customer ID. And if I hit apply, that will basically take the data and do the calculation and give us the count per gender. You can do this. You can do formulas now from this data. So basically, we just pull that data from BigQuery to this Google Sheets spreadsheet. Now, what's also interesting here is that you can also add parameters in your actual SQL statement. And what I mean by that, currently with this setup, we're just going to pull Illinois results. So what I could do, I could go to a different tab. I'm going to call this one settings. And then I'm just going to call state and just type IL for Illinois. So now what I can do, I can use this cell value, this Illinois, in my actual SQL statement. So to do that, I'm going to go back to this. And we need to go back and modify this. So I'm going to click on this connection settings. That's going to get back to this. And here we have this option for parameters. And we can click add. And it's going to ask us for a name. So I'm just going to call this selected state. And then here we're going to do a reference to that cell. So I'll click on this, go to that settings tab, and click on this cell. I'm going to press OK. And I'm going to click add. And you can see when I did that, it did add this at sign with that selected state, which is the name of that parameter in here. So what I can do now, I can grab that. I'm going to cut that out of here. And then instead of having this Illinois as a state, I'm going to delete that, including the single quotes, and paste that parameter name. And with this setup, again, if I do preview results, you should see I get the same thing. And if I connect, we're basically in the same place. So now you can see we got the same results because it's Illinois. But with this setup, now I can go back here and change this to Texas and then go back to this. And if I refresh this, see, now I get my results for Texas because basically I was able to use that parameter in the actual SQL statement. And that's pretty much it. That's how you can pull BigQuery data to your spreadsheet using this connected sheets. So now let's do the exact opposite. Let's grab some data from Google Sheets and move it to BigQuery. And for that, I have this tab, and it's basically a different spreadsheet. And you can see I have some data. The first line in this data is basically column names. And the tab name down here is called customers. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go to that BigQuery setup. And you could add it to any data set. So I'm just going to add it to a different data set, not this one. So I'll just go ahead and create one more data set here in this project. So I'll just go ahead and name this test data. Create this data set. And now within this data set, there will be no tables. I just made it. So I'm going to add this Google Sheets data here as a table within this data set. So what I'll do, I'm going to click on this add data. And here as a source, we're going to find this Google Drive. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to go copy the link to that spreadsheet, this one. Go to here and paste it here. And here as a format, I'm going to choose Google Sheet. And it's going to ask us for a range. So here you can either do the tab name and the range. Or you can just do the tab name if you want to grab the whole thing. So in this case, the tab name is customers. I'm going to copy that. And I'll go here and I'll paste it right there. So that means just grab the whole tab customers. Now, if you want a particular range, you can do exclamation and do something like A1 colon G20 or something like that. I want to grab the whole data. So I'll just go customers like this. That's fine. And now I'm going to choose that data set I made, this test data. So I'll click here and click right there. And the name of the table I want to create within that data set. So I'm going to call this customers data, like that. Should be no spaces here. It did auto correct to have a space, but it shouldn't. So just a single word like that. And then I'm going to leave this as external table. So I'm going to scroll down and auto detect the schema. Again, if you don't understand what this means, go to that video in the description and watch and understand how BigQuery actually works and what these things actually are. One more thing I want to do here, I want to go to this advanced options. And I want to make sure that I explain that that first line is the headers. So I'm going to skip the header row, the first line, which will make it the actual column names. So at this point, I'm going to do create table. And you'll see I got this customer's data table now within this test data data set. So if I click on that, you'll see it lists all these column names, which are basically these column names from this spreadsheet. And at this point, I can just go ahead and write some SQL statements. So I'm going to get rid of this. And let's do select star from, again, the name of this project ID. And then we have dataset test data. And then we have the table customers data, which is this. So at this point, if I just do a semicolon to finish this and hit run, let's just give this a second. There it is. So you can see how it went to that Google Sheet. It grabbed all the data in that spreadsheet and it just pulls it over, which is this data from here. So that's how we can now grab the data from Google Sheet and bring it over to BigQuery. So let me go ahead and quickly sort this alphabetically. So I'm going to go order by that first name column here. So I have this person and that's his last name. So let's go to our spreadsheet and find this person. There it is. So let me change the last name to something else. So now if I go back and rerun this statement, you'll see that it grabs that data because we're basically connected to that spreadsheet with a live connection. And that's the reason why you'll probably notice that this runs a lot slower than a native BigQuery dataset usually. But there it is. Now that's our connection both ways. So from BigQuery to Google Sheets or from Google Sheets to BigQuery, both ways. One of them connected sheets and the other one is just basically using that particular spreadsheet as a data source in our BigQuery dataset. If you have any questions related to this, let me know in the comments section. And as always, thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.